Hey everyone, welcome to my video series on the most downloaded Flipper Zero application from lab.flipper.net, which is the official app store for the Flipper Zero. This video covers the 10 most popular Flipper Zero apps. If you want to start the playlist at 100, click here. Let's get started. Number 10, barcode app. I'll start by creating a barcode. And you can see there's a variety of types. So you have to know which type of barcode you need to create. In my case, I'll do an EAN13, which is from a book. And then for the data, we'll type in our barcode information. Go ahead and click Save. And now we've saved that barcode. We could use Edit Barcode for a similar UI or Load Barcode to load our barcode. Now that our barcode is on our Flipper, we can load it with a scanner or a scanning app. And there's the result from that barcode. Due to the Flipper's small screen, some barcodes are not fully displayed. For example, everything to the left of the red line and to the right of the purple line was not displayed on the Flipper. Number 9, Weather Station. This application uses your sub-gigahertz radio and it supports external radios as well. I'm on 433.92, which is the frequency of the weather stations I'm trying to receive. We can select one of the readings, and there's the temperature information on the bottom. And then on the other one, there's the temperature and the humidity. Number 8, Radio Scanner. This application scans the radio frequencies supported by the Flipper Zero. Use left and right to change the direction of the scan, and up and down to change the sensitivity.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
Number 7, IR Scope. This application helps you visualize infrared signals. So this is what my power signal looks like. And this is what my mute signal looks like. Number 6, Cross Remote. I'll go ahead and edit an existing command. And you can see I'm sending a bunch of infrared commands to turn on the TV and change the source, and then a sub-gigahertz command to turn off my light. So now I'll go up and choose to load that, and you can see my light is currently on. And we'll send that signal, and here it is, the TV's on, it's switching HDMI inputs, it's on the Fire TV now, and it's turned off the light. Number 5, Key Copier. The first step is to choose Select Key Format. Choose the brand of your key. You can see there's a lot of different brands that are now supported. And some of the brands are hard to measure with the Flipper Zero's tiny screen. I'll go ahead and choose a KW1 key. And filming it to show the camera angle is even harder since there's a thickness of the glass of the Flipper Zero. But this key is fairly basic, and we're just making those grooves go down to where our key is. And so you can see that it's 23454. Be sure to check out Talking Sasquatch's video where he 3D prints a key using the values from this application. In my case, the key actually had the number printed on it. Some keys are close enough. For example, here I'll choose an SC4, but I actually have an SC1. And so the difference is that in an SC4, there are 6 positions, and in an SC1, there's only 5. So what we're going to see is that for me to get down to these deep grooves, I'm going to have to, in some cases, change the next number and then I can go deeper because there's a maximum delta between each of these cuts. So sometimes you have to kind of go back and forth to get the right depths. But we should be able to do this with this key and figure out all five numbers. That looks about right. And I think I need to go down one more. Yep, there we go. Perfect. So our actual number is 38578. And that last number we wouldn't use. Number 4, spectrum analyzer. The Flipper Zero can only tune one frequency at a time. So this application is quickly scanning a range of frequencies and showing us the signal strength at that frequency. So you can see that I have a remote that keeps transmitting around 433 megahertz. And we can use left and right to change which region of the spectrum we are doing. And then OK drills into a more narrow region. So we can see my signal is right around 433.9 megahertz. Number 3, BT Trigger. This application uses Bluetooth, and it'll show as control and the name of your flipper. Note, you can pair with an iOS device or an Android device. Type the pairing code into your phone and then click OK. And then the flipper app will be ready to control your phone. And I'll do a delay of 1 second per shot. You can use up and down to change the speed or right arrow for a single shot. Number 2, ESP32 Wi-Fi Marauder. We'll choose yes for saving our PCAPs and the log files to our Flipper Zero. We can scan access points. And I typically let that run a couple of minutes. And then we can go to list access points and find our hardware. In my case, it'll be the 42nd item. And then we can go to select access point and then type in the item number that you found from your list. Make sure it's the correct number that matches your hardware. You really don't want to be running this on someone else's hardware. And you can see there's all kinds of different Wi-Fi and Bluetooth tests you can run. Some ESP32s have Bluetooth and others don't. In our case, we're going to be focused in sniffing traffic, and we're going to sniff that Wi-Fi traffic to make a PCAP file on our Flipper Zero. So in sniff, we're going to choose the PMKID, and I'm going to do an active force deauth. And again, remember, I've selected my hardware access point. So this is running against my access point and not my neighbor's hardware. And then once that's run for a while on QFlipper, we'll be able to find that PCAP file. And then we can go to an online tool to get our hashes. We can submit our hash to an online tool, or we can run hashcat locally against our own password file and see if we can calculate the password. And my access point was configured with one of the 1 million most common passwords. Again, only run this on your own hardware. And the number one most downloaded Flipper Zero app is the RFID detector. Put your Flipper Zero against an RFID reader, and it will show you if it's using NFC or low frequency RFID. I did have one reader where touch the reader didn't show anything, but when I put a low frequency badge near the reader, It showed that the reader supports both low frequency and NFC. Thanks for watching this video series. Please like and subscribe, and leave a comment below letting me know which application you found the most helpful.